thinking about my dad all day. He'd be really, really proud of this, that we're doing this. He'd be really, really happy. So I hope he's sort of looking down, and this is for him.
He passed away, which opened up my mind to, like, where is he? Which opens up the bigger question of what do you believe in?
And Corbin, knowing that his father was in the business, show business, as many of the friends were in show business, he learned a lot of what he is today in the entertainment world from the people he was around and from his father. I think he got the best of his father, naturally.
Hey, I had this idea for this movie, Rust, and there's a relationship between the main character and his father, and then my dad died. I'd started writing it, but I didn't really get much going, didn't have a lot of energy into it. And then my dad died in May, and it just seems that it flowed out right after that. And I think it's the kind of movie that he'd be proud that I was making. And there's also a relationship that the father and son having this, just trying to please your dad. Did you do enough to make him proud? You know, where do we fall short? What are the expectations that a father has of a son? All that stuff was sort of hanging out there for me with my dad, always has been, and you know, personally, it didn't matter how much I accomplished, he would always think there could be more. Like, if I got a nomination for LA Law, great, what movies are you gonna do? You know, the thing that drives this movie is this guy who's come back to this town, whose father tells him very clearly, you never finish anything. Same notion of pushing him to do something. It's that notion of the father pushing the son to higher ground, you know? And that's really the motivational thing in it.
I'm gonna bring some of his ashes here. I won't sprinkle them here. I'll put them in Kipling somewhere. So I sprinkled some of his ashes in London, at this place where he did this play, and some in Rome where he discovered a play, which is all pretty funny because I was sprinkling ashes. People look like I was a terrorist on a street in London. But I'm going to put some of his ashes up here. That'd be good. Then he'll be with me. Then he'll be with me up here.
All right, so we have one last little piece of business here. My dad was very instrumental in me writing this movie, and we're on our last day here, and I brought with me a little bit of his ashes here. Meet my dad. I've been wondering, I've been going through the whole shoot trying to wonder where I'm going to leave. I wanted to leave a little bit of him and Kipling, and we've been at the cemetery. We've been at, well, there's my screen dad. Hey, come here a second. I want you to meet my dad.
Hi.
It's my dad.
Really?
It's my real dad.
Oh, wow.
I'm gonna leave a little of him here in Kipling. I'm just trying to decide where. Mm. What do you think? Center of Main Street, just right here in the intersection?
Sure.
I mean, ashes get scattered anyway, yeah. Right? So, Dad, you're going to Main Street. My TV dad, my movie dad.
I love you. I love you too.
So much.
Thanks so much.
It's such a joy.
You've been great.
So did you.
Can't wait to see you back here and show you the movie. You're great. You are really, really good at it. You know that. Well, you saw it. You see it. I see the rest of them. All right. I'm going to go.
Bless you.
All right. See ya. Wow, that must mean something for him to show up right there. That was not planned. So I've been thinking I want to do it right in the middle of Main Street here. We've been a lot of places, pretty places, cemeteries. I was thinking about doing it over at that farmhouse we burned down, but that's kind of evil over there. That feels weird. That wasn't right. I think I'd do it out on the sports field, because we always played sports. But
I'm going to always remember this middle of the street here as our kind of crossroads where everything happened. So, I let all these people go so they don't think I'm freaking out.
Those were real emotional times, and I can feel where he's coming from. He wanted to leave a part of him and his dad behind. So, you know, he didn't come here as a fly-by-nighter. He came here with the depth of his heart and put it all there.
And from the little clip that I seen the other night, I see the passion that he had for Kipling, and he did capture it. I can see Kipling through his eyes now.
You inspired this entire project. The place where it all happened. You won't get to see this movie, but you're very much a part of it. I love you. It's Kipling.